Good morning, everyone. My name is Chris Costopoulos, and I have the privilege of being the hostess for our December Student of the Month breakfast, the last one for 2016. Hard to believe, but in a few short weeks, we are going to be on break, and then the next time we're all back together, it's 2017. We had our future freshman night earlier this month, and the incoming freshman class is the class of 2021. It just sounded so futuristic. And so it's, you know, time is flying. But while we are here today, we are going to hear about the wonderful things that your sons and daughters have been doing in their classes that have set them apart from the other 2,000 kids in this building, which is really saying something for them, your students, your children, our students, who together we raised. And you have them for three quarters of the day, we get them for the other quarter, or that's not exactly right. We get them for a third of the day. I was never good at math, so please forgive me. Math teachers in here, sorry. But you know, together through the teen years, we kind of raised your children together. I think we get to see the best parts of them, and we're gonna hear about those best parts now. First up, from our music department, Mr. Jan Matthews is going to introduce us to McKenna Cook. And of course, they have the long walk up, so it's like walking down the runway. And the students get to be embarrassed by coming up and standing next to the teachers, okay?
Hi, everybody. So we stand up close, right? My name is Jan Matthews. I teach orchestra. McKenna next to me, her story is part of my story. This year is the first year that I'm a full-time orchestra teacher. The last 3 years I was part-time, so I would come in and teach two classes every day, and then run off and go be a private teacher in the evenings. And even though I knew the building, I knew my students, I knew my fellow teachers, the grind of being here for as long as you are, and all the responsibilities it's, you know, eye-opening. So then I have, now I'm talking to teachers, you know how some students can take up all your energy, and every moment that you're not with them, you're thinking about how can I make the class a better place for some of these students that need so much from you. And then you wake up to an email from McKenna on a Monday morning that says, "Hello, Mr. Matthews. There's a student named in here that I'm not going to name. I hope you had, where did you jump? Come on back. Technology. No, that's the wrong one. I'm sorry, I had it all ready to go. Let's see, one more time. She wished me a good weekend. And here we go. I hope you had a relaxing weekend and are enjoying the fresh snow. I noticed on Friday that the student wasn't very excited about chamber group assignments coming up. If she's worried about not getting along with anyone in her group, I wouldn't mind being assigned to a group with her if that's any help at all. She's very nice and is amazing at the violin. I would love to be in a group with her." McKenna has always been selfless to a T. There's not a day that she doesn't come in with a huge smile and says, "Good morning, Mr. Matthews. Happy Monday, happy Tuesday, happy Wednesday, happy Thursday, happy Friday." With her cow suits and her soft toys that she sometimes wears and brings to class, she brightens up everybody's space, everybody's life. She is a reminder of, while teaching can be tough, you're not doing it alone. While there's colleagues that can help, there's students that are helpful like this. So for all these reasons, I nominated McKenna as Orchestra Student of the Month.
In the season of giving, it's so refreshing to see someone giving of themselves and wanting to help someone else. That's awesome, McKenna. Now from the art department, Mrs. Ray is going to introduce us to Jacob Hoekstra.
Hi, morning. Jacob has been faced with many challenges this semester in digital photo art. A program that froze on him and he lost his entire work for the day. Plus a computer that was acting up on him and therefore has had to play musical chairs on several occasions using various computers from day to day. While all of this was going on, he still had a smile on his face, was patient, and just kept working. I want to recognize Jacob for what I've observed in the classroom, such as attention to detail, solving challenges independently, and navigating his way through multiple programs, photo assignments, and deadlines. However, it is more of what he has shown me that he is accomplishing outside the classroom that makes it even more exciting. Jacob has taken the time to really explore how his digital camera works, truly investigated all of the camera functions, and has come back to class with some really spectacular images outside of the curriculum assignments. Jacob is excited about his own creations, continues to amaze me with his willingness to move forward, even when faced with multiple encounters, and is the type of student who has shown he loves learning new things. Thank you, Jacob, for the positive contribution you bring to class and for being a role model for others.
I wished you'd brought with you some of the samples of his work. My father was a professional photographer. I grew up with a dark room in our basement. I specialized in the old black and white, and he did amazing things. My nickname for him was Ansel Adams, and he's not with us any longer, but I often wondered what he would have been able to do in this digital age, because he had quite the eye. So it's an outstanding field to be able to capture memories and for all prosperity. And so keep that up. You're going to use that for the rest of your life if it doesn't even become a career for you. Okay. Now from our language arts, social studies, we have two teachers, Virginia Condon and Jennifer Setsky, who are going to introduce us to two students, Lorenzo Esquivel and Noe Hernandez. Again, they're doing the long walk down the red carpet. Mm-hmm. See, Mr. Goldman knew what he was doing. All right.
So we have the distinct pleasure of honoring two students. We like to call them the dynamic duo. And so one of them is not here. His name is Lorenzo, and this is Noe Hernandez. We couldn't nominate one without nominating the other. They truly are exceptional students in every way, not just academically, but you know, what stands out the most about the two of them is that in studies, it's an English and history course combined together for a double period. So we get to know our students very well because we see them for 2 full hours a day. And we do a lot of group activities. And so the room is somewhat disheveled on a day-to-day basis with 50 kids in there, and lots of group environment activities. And Noe and Lorenzo, at the end of the day, are always, always after class helping us put back the room. And you know, regardless of what they have going on, they're just always around to help. They're polite, they're kind, they're thoughtful. They're everything that a parent would want their child to be. And so we will adopt them if they are, available. So we just love having them in class. I'm hogging the microphone as usual.
Yes, per usual.
Per usual. I'm happens. Virginia. This is Jen.
And I'm Jennifer. The shorter one, the taller one always takes over.
I have on heels today.
I know. So anyway, Noe is here. I will speak for Lorenzo. And Noe. They are truly gifts in our class. As parents and teachers, you understand about teenagers, they're either asleep in the morning or asleep a period 7-8, and Noe and Lorenzo are not asleep. They're the ones that keep things going, and they're also the ones, Mr. Matthews, that are the happy Monday, happy Tuesday, just that smile every day. It just kind of invigorates us, and yes, it is a thrill to have them in class. And all of my children are out of the house, so truly the adoption thing is open. I would be happy to take them. So congratulations, Noe. As part of the dynamic duo, we are very proud of you.
Here,
think it's kind of great that one dynamic duo nominated another dynamic duo. That's awesome. You're each other's Batman and Robin. Now, from business education, Ryan Gerritsen is going to introduce us to Alexa Salinas.
Morning. Okay, so Alexa. Alexa may be one of the smartest students I have here at LT, no exaggeration. Not once has she given me less than a brilliant and well thought out answer to a question I asked of her. On top of being really smart, she has a great sense of humor. Here's how I know, because she laughs at my jokes. Right? I'm funny. Alexa, being really smart and funny, two qualities you possess, will take you really far in life, I promise. You also have it in you to continue experiencing success when faced with challenging situations and continue becoming a better and better person. Having this attribute allows us to grow as individuals, and I can only hope my own children possess this. If you keep pushing yourself and keep working hard, you may not realize it yet, but with the combination of skills and attributes you possess, I promise you can go places you never imagined. I know the future is bright, young lady. To Alexa's parents, please continue doing whatever it is you are doing at home because it's working. Thank you.
Okay, we're gonna get her a new one, because if you use those pens, you get A's, okay, on your papers. Now, from Family and Consumer Sciences, Lauren Engelhart is gonna introduce us to Laura Whalen.
All right, hi. I'm Lauren Engelhart with the Family and Consumer Sciences Department, and this is Lauren Whalen, and she is in my child development course. At the end of an email once, she even said, P.S., you have a fantastic first name, and I agree, because we both share the same name. Okay. All right, Lauren is a joy to have in class. She really prides herself on doing the best that she can with her work. And she is in the preschool class, so we have a lot of little ones, 12 preschoolers throughout both of the days that the preschoolers come. So there's a lot of chaos going on, and Lauren does a really great job with that. She shows passion and creativity in the preschool lab, and it has been so fun to watch her take on a teaching and leadership role. Lauren brings so much positivity to the classroom, and it is so refreshing to have a student who works hard and does a great job. Lauren currently has the highest grade in my second hour class, and not only is she smart and dedicated to her schoolwork, but she is a natural with preschoolers. She also just shared with me this morning that she has babysat with four kids before, all under the age of, what was it? Like six, so she is a natural at this, and she's doing it all the time. I look forward to watching her continued success in my class because I know she has a bright future. And like I said, she really is a natural. So thank you, Lauren, for being such a great student.
Lauren also brightens the hall. She's one of those students that when she sees you will always smile. Even if she doesn't know you or know you well, she'll just smile and just make the day just a little bit brighter. So that's awesome. Now from business education, Mr. Wolf is going to introduce us to Jared Belcher.
Good morning. My name is Brian Wolf. This is Jared. He's a student of the month. Jared's one of those kids that you always hope to have in class. The kind of kid that exudes responsibility, attention to detail, and just an overall kind disposition. A lot of big words, sorry. It's not always about the academics in the school, but it's nice to have a student that possesses a combination of intellectual abilities and this humbleness. You don't always get that, you know? So when you tell a kid, boy, you just rocked on that test, he's like, thanks. I'm like, no, you killed it. Thanks. In this semester, Jared has completed all of his work and he's taken advantage of, I think, 99% of the opportunities to raise or attempt new projects. He's a fine example of what being a good student is, an even better person. I'm proud to nominate this young man for Student of the Month, and he exemplifies it in every possible way.
Jared, I thought he was going to keep the pen for himself there for a moment.
I did last year.
Okay. Now from Social Studies, Mr. Morrison is going to introduce us to Claire O'Connor. Down the red carpet she comes.
Good morning, my name is Michael Morrison. I am in the Social Studies Department here at Lyons Township High School. And it's an honor to be here this morning with you and an honor to be standing here next to Claire. I have a paragraph here that Claire will read and over the years and her kids will find in the attic, you know, in 100 years or whatever. But I just wanted to say, you know, I'm not from here and this place is awesome. And I think a lot of you are from here and you've sent a lot of kids here and you're kind of used to LT. And the reason LT is awesome is because of Claire O'Connor and because of all the kids in this room and because of all the parents. And every morning I have the honor of coming here, and every morning I have the honor of teaching Claire. And as she's leaving my class, no matter how busy I am, no matter what's going on, Claire says, "Thank you, Mr. Morrison," and she walks out. And kids do things like that, and they might not even realize they're doing them, and they do them, and you're like, you know what, I think I'll come back tomorrow, right? Because they're just great, special kids, and Claire exemplifies that. Claire is why North Campus is like a college. Claire is willing to participate and give examples from her life. She's not afraid to be smart in front of her peers, which I think is very valuable about the two campus system we have here, where it's cool to be smart and it's cool to be motivated. And it's just an honor to teach Claire. And I thank her father, I thank her parents for this amazing woman that they've raised. And I know she's gonna do great in the future. She's planning on majoring in engineering at a bunch of schools that I was nowhere near getting into. So I know she'll be very successful. So thank you to Claire and thank you to her family for the honor of teaching her. Claire O'Connor.
Claire, that's awesome that you're going into engineering. We need more women in STEM careers. That's awesome. From the Physical Education Department, Ms. Myers nominated Maddie Walsh, but she cannot be here. So I'm going to share why she nominated Maddie. And then tell you a little bit about Maddie that I know. Okay. I have had the fortune of having Maddie Walsh in this year's sports officiating course. Officiating is a course where students learn the rules, techniques, and mechanics from the position of a sports referee, umpire, or official. This is a field that, as we all know, is highly scrutinized by fans, parents, and players alike. In class, this can be a daunting task. When everyone wants to win, emotions run high, and it's an official's job to control the pace and the overall dynamic of a game. Sports officiating is also a field dominated by men. On top of all these factors, Maddie not only manages everything with confidence and composure, she is also one of the three females in a class of 26 students. I am continually impressed by Maddie's positive attitude in the face of player scrutiny and chaos. She controls the situation with ease. In fact, she controls a class of 25 sports enthusiasts without the students even realizing it. Maddie is a young woman who leads with positivity and fairness. She assures confidence and comfort in the players and people around her. It has been a special semester having this strong female in class. It is because of young females like Maddie that even the playing field for young men and women, that evens the playing field for young men and women alike. Okay, now that's what Ms. Myers told you about her. I've known Maddie since she was a freshman. She and I worked together on the Relay for Life, which she is a very dedicated member to. And but she's not always able to come to all the meetings because she's also in the marching band. She's also in the theater. The list of things that this young lady is involved in is mind-boggling. I would hate to see what the refrigerator calendar looks like. You know, if they do it like the color code by event, it's the rainbow of every color. It's a 68 Crayola box because she's involved in so many things. And in every single one of them, she's giving 110%. And like so many of you in the room, she's also looking out for the other kids that are also involved. And she's, like I was telling her parents earlier, it's like, look out world, Maddie's coming, you know? And I'm not sure where she's gonna end up and what she's gonna do in the future, but I know she's gonna be a success at it and that she will just change it and make whatever field she goes better just by being a part of it. She's one of those students that even when you see her in the hall and she says hi, you're done. You've had a better day. It's, you know, like Mr. Morrison had said, I'm going to come back tomorrow because Maddie's there, you know. And, you know, I see her in the halls and it's, you know, being at the same campus with her is awesome. And I can't say enough about her. She is one that I would take home. I would adopt her in a heartbeat. And she'd probably clean my house, make dinner, and, you know, wrap that stack of Christmas presents I haven't gotten around to yet. So she's just this fantastic young woman who is going to set the world on fire.
ALT, at this time, please join me in observing a moment of silence.
And we're going to have a moment of silence for a moment, okay?
And now, please stand for the saying of the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, LT, and have a great day.
Well, now you know how your students start their day, okay? And if it was Monday, we'd also have announcements. So it's a good thing it's Thursday, okay? So once again, Maddie is just this wonderful human being and makes the world a better place by just being part of it. So I am happy that she was not here to read this for you so that I could say something super nice about you because you deserve everything, okay? Okay, moving on. From science, Mr. Murphy is going to introduce us to Jose Gonzalez. You're looking very dashing with your scarf there, Mr. Murphy.
It's cold outside.
It is. I don't think we're going to hit 30 today. So winter is officially here.
As the astronomy teacher here, I have to say winter is not officially here until December 22nd, but we'll let that go. So I'm Kevin Murphy. I do teach astronomy and AP Physics. This is Jose Gonzalez. He's in my eighth period astronomy class. I'm not as much as I love my job, I am not a fan of eighth period teachers. Can I get an amen? Matter of fact, I think we should rename it something like our buildings don't have a 13th floor a lot of times. We just not name eighth period. But this is exactly why Jose is my student of the month, because I'll be working along, and astronomy is a pretty lab-intensive class, and a lot of students, I think they believe the bell rings at 2:45. It's actually 3:05, and they'll be packing up, and even at 3, people are packing up, and the bell will ring, and people will wander out. And I'll turn around, and Jose will still be working, and then apologizing to me. Oh, Mr. Murphy, I know you need to go, but I just want to get this taken care of. And this is the kind of student that he is all the time, and even after when we have a lecture, it will end the class, and everybody's streaming out, and I've got my scarf on, normally because I'm just still wearing it. Jose will still have a couple of really interesting questions, and really just is so interested in the class, and just really involved, and it's such a joy to have that end my day. So for that, Jose is Student of the Month. Congratulations.
I did realize my error when I said that. I want you to know that, okay? Now from Student Services, Mr. Zeroli is going to introduce us to Noor Abu Saf. There's always a few names that I need help in pronouncing.
Hi, I'm Mike Zeroli, one of the counselors here at LT, junior counselor, and this is Noor Abu Saf. Congratulations, Noor. It was a pleasure meeting your parents today who are here celebrating with us. One thing that stood out for me, for Noor, is she's a transfer student, and transferring into LT is very difficult. You know, LT prides themselves on, you know, we pride ourselves on having a rigorous environment for students, and we see students transfer from neighboring schools and often struggle. Now, Noor transferred from Syria, and she's been in Syria, living in Syria the last 8 years. And, you know, I went to check on her a couple of months in, you know, after we had, you know, initially met and met a few times that first couple of weeks to make sure she was acclimated. But when I met with her, I was pleasantly surprised to see she pretty much had all A's, no complaints, and the only thing she said she was working on was losing a little bit of her accent. So I think that says a lot about her, a lot about her work ethic, things that her parents have instilled in her. She has very, very strong goals. I know she's interested in potentially the medical field, but she's keeping her options open. She wants to study here in the United States, and just a great example of hard work, determination, and being independent. So congratulations, Noor.
Noor, do they have winters like this in Syria? I didn't think so. Okay. How are you handling this so far? If you need a scarf, Mr. Murphy has some. Also from Student Services, Ms. Whiting is going to introduce us to two students, Courtney Lewis and Charlotte Tricarton, who are also two amazing young ladies, might I add.
Good morning. I'm Jean Whiting from Student Services, and I am the Student Assistance Program Coordinator. And part of my responsibility then is to work with the community in several different capacities. And so I have nominated these two young ladies as part of their work with our newly formed township coalition for a drug-free Lyons Township. I think that's the name. We renamed it recently this year. And if any of you have ever done community work, you know that sometimes there are lots of small steps to be taken before you feel some success. But these two young ladies to my right are so passionate and so committed to taking those steps that they truly are an inspiration for the adults who attend the meetings. I'm going to start with Courtney. Courtney's kind of a two-year veteran. She's been involved in the coalition. This is her second year. And she has done a lot of community work. She works with the leadership as well. And I really don't know how she finds the time to be present at our Monday evening meetings every month. But Courtney is a religious attender and supporter. Sometimes, you know, on a Monday, it can be hard to extend your day, and the meetings are at 5 o'clock, and we will muse to ourselves, do you think any of the kids will be there? And the response is, Courtney will be there. We know Courtney will be there, and she is. She goes from her school day to a youth meeting at 4 o'clock, to a coalition meeting at 5 o'clock, and then sometimes even to work after that. And her dedication to all of those endeavors is just inspiring to me. Charlotte is a new member this year, and I have been also impressed with her dedication and her commitment to try to make a difference to her peers. I told Charlotte earlier that I knew I was going to nominate her for Student of the Month. During our Red Ribbon Week, I walked into the counseling office after school one day, and there's Charlotte with her backpack taking out all of our decorating supplies. And I'm like, Charlotte, do you need any help? No, I got this, Miss Whiting. And as she's planning, I'm just going to do this, and then I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to do this. And so she truly was, a big driver for some of the things that we did during Red Ribbon Week this year, and we really appreciated her efforts. So I wanted to recognize them. I think it's a special thing for youth to be involved in community service, to give back to not only their peers, their school, but also the community at large, and I really have enjoyed working with them so far this year. So thank you very much for your efforts.
I serve on that coalition with them, and I think one of the most impressive things about those two students is that, you know, you're sitting in a room and there's police officers, there's the CEO of Robert Crown, and a lot of high-powered people, and they are not afraid to share their thoughts, their insights about students and what they think, you know, problems are and solutions are, and it's just awesome to see. So the coalition is in good hands, okay? Last but certainly not least, Mr. Geddes is going to introduce us to Maria Sarambitska.
In case you're wondering why it is that the students are all able to somehow land on the same spot, there's an X on the floor that Ms. Fay put there to make sure that they're in shot. Well done, Ms. Kostopoulos, on the name. Chris was very nervous before we got started getting Maria's name right. I don't know what it is. I think there's something about difficult names that leads to leadership, that maybe they kind of feel like they have to compensate because you can't pronounce their name right. They're going to make sure that you know who they are. But Maria's very much done that. Maria's followed what I would say is a typical path for most of the kids who become leaders in student council. Typically what we see is that as freshmen, students are a little reticent. They don't really push themselves out there yet because they're trying to find their place in a group of, on some days, 140 or 150 students at a student council meeting. And so they spend their freshman year acclimating. And then sometime usually late first semester or second semester of their sophomore year, they start to step forward. They take on leadership roles in student council. And then junior year, they really blossom. And that's what Maria has done. That's the typical path. However, Maria is anything but typical. While the way that she has gotten there is something that we've seen before, it hasn't been a very typical way because Maria is extremely social. Maria is extremely friendly, and she likes people, and people genuinely like her. So it's been somewhat heartening to watch her grow despite not having an officer position. Now, as a student council sponsor, we don't have a formal curriculum like most of the classroom teachers do, and we don't have ways to check in and make sure that the students are incorporating the lessons that we're trying to provide them through student council. So all we can do is give them opportunities and trust that they are taking advantage of those opportunities and learning. And every once in a while, we'll get a confirmation that a student is actually learning the leadership lessons that we're trying to impart upon them. Things like taking on a chair position for an upcoming event, or volunteering to stay late after a student council meeting, or come in early and put in the extra work that student council requires besides that hour-long meeting on a Wednesday. And this year in particular, Maria has demonstrated that she's learned those lessons. She took active roles in planning this year's homecoming assemblies and the various things that were related to homecoming. She was a very active, probably the most active member of student council in getting our first blood drive launched at the beginning of the year. And she's also very, very involved in the planning for this year's all-school assembly. But I think the moment that crystallized for me that it had gotten through to Maria and that she was ready to take that next step was when she came up to me after just after homecoming, and she said, Mr. Geddes, I want to be an officer next year. That's great, Maria. What role do you want? I don't know, but I want to be an officer. The fact that she didn't know a particular position, a particular role of power, I guess you would say, that she wanted. She just knew that she wanted the additional responsibility. In that moment, I knew that Maria had incorporated all the lessons that we were hoping to impart to all of our student council members. So in the year and a half that I will have left with Maria, I look very forward to seeing her blossom into an even more impressive young woman than she already is. And that's why we were very honored to recognize Maria as our North Campus Student of the Month for Student Council. Congratulations.
Maria, not all leaders have titles. Okay, you're definitely have proven to be one. That concludes our Student of the Month breakfast. You know, we're coming into a crazy time. There's 2 weeks, two weeks exactly, till winter solstice, I think, is the last day of school. A little astronomy reference there. And it's a twofold bittersweet kind of day. It's the longest darkness of the year, correct? But it's our last day of school. So, you know, might not be enough sunshine for me, but we're all going to get out for winter break. So, you know, there are definitely some things exciting about that. So that is how we will celebrate the winter solstice this year. We'll send everybody home for 2 weeks. And it's that 2 weeks when you're not with us that I would like to talk to you about for just a quick moment. You all are in this room because you have done amazing things in your classrooms, but mostly you are in this room because of your character. Almost every single one of you, your teacher talked about your character, not so much about, you know, yeah, you got a good grade on your test, blah, 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 but it's how you respond to that. It is how you treat your classmates, how you treat your teachers. It's those intrinsic things that you can't really teach in school. Those are the things that mom and dad taught you along the way. And you have 2 weeks at home with them. Put away the phones. Set some time apart to just be with your family. You're all so busy, you know, running around and doing everything and changing the world. And it needs changing, so keep doing that. But don't forget those people that are in your house that have stood by you. Oof, I'm gonna cry. And love you, okay? Someday they won't be there. So spend time with them and turn off the phone, okay? Please, I see you guys texting each other, sitting next to each other in restaurants texting each other. It drives me crazy, okay? Get out the board games, dust them off. Watch a holiday movie together, even if it's a corny Hallmark movie. Do things together. You've got those 2 weeks, those are a gift. Take them, make the most of them, and then we'll see you back here on January 10th, which is another gift because it seems so far away. But take that time. Make sure that you make memories with your family, okay? Soon enough, you're all gonna be off to college and you're not gonna have those opportunities, so do it now, okay, everybody? Have a wonderful holiday season, however you celebrate. And just remember the one common thing amongst all of the holidays that are celebrated this time of year is love. So love each other. Thank you.